Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take on its reaction to the song Rock and Roll Suicide. It's a song by David Bowie and it's a request of our patron David. We have reacted to a few songs of David Bowie by far and we have enjoyed his music, his way of singing, his way of creating music and songs. And this time it is yet another new song for us, Rock and Roll Suicide. Let's listen to it and see what it is about.
Yeah, it's New Year's Eve in Mumbai.
It is, yes.
Wish you a happy New Year wherever you are joining us from in the world. Whether it's the UK, US, Canada, Down Under. If it's from Down Under, then it's obviously already New Year for you.
You beat us.
Yeah. And to everyone joining from Asia as well, from where we are located. So happy New Year 2020. Hope you have an amazing, peaceful, joyful 2020. And hope all goes well. And if you're about to, just a small suggestion, if you're about to sign or going to sign any document, whether financial,
important document,
or any other important document that has a date on it, make sure that the date is completely 2020, not just 20. Because someone could add in 01 to 19 or even 20 after that and it would change everything. 01 to 019, 019. So it could change the date. So for example, if it's just 1-1-20, you could make it 1-1-2001 and it would look like you signed the document 20 years ago.
No, it was easier for the year 2000 as well. Only double zeros and people would understand.
Yeah, yeah.
But not with 2020, you really have to write it.
Let's get started. David Bowie, Rock and Roll Suicide.
Time takes a cigarette, puts it in your mouth. You pull on your finger, then another finger, then cigarette. The water wall is calling, it lingers, then you forget. Oh, 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 you're a rock and roll suicide. You're too old to lose it, too young to choose it. And the clock waits so patiently on your song. You walk past the cafe, but you don't eat when you've lived too long. Oh no, 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 you're a rock and roll suicide. Shift break for snarling as you stumble across the road. But the day breaks instead, so you hurry home. Don't let the sun blast your shadow. Don't let the milk float rob your mind. They're so natural, religiously unkind. Oh no, love, you're not alone. You're watching yourself, but you're too unfair.
Very, very powerful. Very pertinent lyrics, you know, which may have been written 40, 50 years ago, but it's so relevant even in 2020.
Mm-hmm.
We are at the start of 2020, New Year's Eve tonight.
Yeah, yeah. Just few hours.
2020. It's basically 2020. Yeah, it's a wonderful time of year. Makes everyone smile,
giggle,
feel good, giggle, chuckle, laugh. And that's the way it should be all year round for all of us. You know? Give me your hands because you're wonderful.
Because you're wonderful.
That's the spirit.
You're not alone.
It's very pertinent lyrics, so I'll tell you why before we go to Kirti's thoughts and feelings.
Okay.
As a pure reactor to this David Bowie song. What very pertinent lyrics, because we live in a world where most of us tend to be alone, even feel very lonely at times. So, you know, if we realize that we are not the only ones and there are many like us, and we find a way to unite with them, it will be amazing. Yeah.
Join hands together.
What are your thoughts?
I like the song. You know, when it started, it had a sad undertone when only he was singing and some of the music was playing. The drums weren't yet in. And after a few lines, the rock and roll vibe came in the song when everything started playing. And the music was moving with the lines of the song. Like every bit of the music was made for each line that he was singing. It was in sync, not like a song which has music constructed and the vocals constructed separately. And they do their job and the vocalist. This was, you know, two flowing together. The vocals and the music were together. He was taking it one by one and the music was coming right after him, wherever it needed to be. Like an orchestra, like things happen in an orchestra. So I enjoyed the song. This was rock and roll society. I'm assuming it's about the people in the rock and roll industry. And he's trying to tell them, you're not the only one who feels run down, who feels low, who feels sad. You are just wonderful. Give me your hand. We both can be together. Let's fight things together if you have any trouble. That's what I'm thinking. If anything else you found out, I don't know.
For me, it's in general also. You know, okay. Maybe a specific case or written for a specific group of people.
I thought for musicians.
But I feel it's in general. You know, why would... maybe talking about himself, you know, looking in the mirror and writing a song down like that. It could be about himself at that phase in his life, that this is because he says, oh, you're a rock and roll suicide. But apart from that, I think it's mainly to anyone, whether it's the fans, whether it's the listeners of the song, whether it's anyone who happens to listen to it, chances upon the lyrics while running through it online or researching lyrics like that. I think anyone it will connect with if they feel alone. If they feel lost, if they
feel especially confused, towards the end of the song, yes.
And if they feel lonely because of a result of being alone and lost and confused in the world that they live in. So it could be for anyone. In my case, it's general. It could be for a specific person or persons. But for me, it also is for anyone. You know, time is running out. You know, it just passes you by. It starts off with comparing time to a cigarette. And it's just passing you by, you know, with each puff, with each breath of smoke that you inhale and exhale, time is just passing you by in the same way. Suddenly it's the next cigarette. Same way time, it's the next moment, it's the next hour, it's the next day. So time is just passing you by and you're possibly facing things on your own. You're on your own. We come into the world alone, we go alone. There are some countries which believe in that kind of philosophy and the whole economy and lifestyle is constructed around these philosophies that is all about independence and living alone and being alone. But there's a price to pay for that, you know, especially if you've lived in a third world nation like ours or a developing country like India or many parts of Asia and Africa. You know, it's definitely the opposite. So here we are always with other people. We are not born alone and neither do we die alone. We may be born only one, but there's so many people around us for that. You know, you could catch a disease the moment you're born in the hospital or a nursing home. Similarly, when you die, you know, you very rarely will you find someone in a nation like India or different parts of Africa dying alone. There'll always be people around you. But there are plenty of countries in Europe and even in other parts of the West where people do die alone.
Very true. They do live alone and die.
They die alone. Yeah. In fact, in a couple of countries, 1 in 4 people die alone. You know, so they are discovered dead by a neighbor because of the stench, stink. Neighbor, a passerby, someone who happens to pass by their home or condo. And when it's a huge apartment complex, like in Sweden, it takes sometimes 3 weeks, 4 weeks for the body to be discovered, you know. Mm-hmm. So it's that's how the lifestyle is, you know. There's a price to pay. So here he's talking about that, I feel, you know. Mm-hmm. The deeper impact of it, that they, you know, sometimes you're just all alone. Mm-hmm. So let's not be alone. Let's take each other's hands. Let's be together. Let's form a community, a club. Let's meet regularly and things of that. Like it happens in Sweden, you know, they have this so many secret societies and clubs which meet regularly, hundreds of them, dozens of them in the forest or someone's home.
Organized activities for people.
Yeah, so that they can bond, they can fondle, they can hug, they can, you know, have some physical touch and companionship at the same time, discuss things without the rest of the world shunning or, you know, looking down upon them or saying this is not to be done in our society. So it's a wonderful song, and perhaps this was written when he was in Berlin, Germany, because at that time Berlin, the lifestyle may have been pretty similar to Sweden and Denmark and some other countries close by.
You know, there is a concept of living that is individualism, or, you know, very close to existentialism as well. For me, I think this song was on the lighter note when he was talking about when you're dedicated to music and the only thing you do is music. Rock and roll society. This is what your home is. This is what your life is. This is what your hobby is. This is what you sniff and this is what you eat. So when this is how hardcore you are into something, you may feel bored of it, you may feel like getting out of it, but you're too young. There was a line where it said, you're too old to lose it, you're too young to choose it. When you chose it, probably you weren't aware of things that would transpire later on, that would unfold later on. And now you're way too old to withdraw yourself out of it. It's for any profession as well, when you get too deep into things, and after that you want to get out of there, it becomes like a suicidal attempt then. That you can't really pull yourself out of there. You're stuck in there. That's kind of an end, and you don't see yourself moving any further because it's a saturation point, and you can't come back from there because that will be disastrous on your part. So he's saying, you're not the only one. There are a lot of us. I'm here. You're wonderful. Give me your hand. Let's do things, figure things out together.
Yeah, in a tiny way, it's like reaction channels on YouTube.
Yeah.
You know, at one time, all those channels which appeared, not one time, just a few months ago,
yeah,
all those channels that seemed to be flourishing and very happy, they would react to music very happily
with all
and nicely.
The
and
I would, spirit,
I enjoy watching them, you know, off and on in my free time, but all of them today, most of them are so sad and depressed, and you know, their reactions also, I mean, they hardly make any, first of all.
Yeah.
You know, the biggest ones, even if you see Lost in Vegas and Alex Hefner, the so-called biggest reactors.
Weibo was there. Weibo and started,
all. Yeah, I mean, all of them, they hardly make reactions these days, and even if they do, they appear to be kind of sad and depressed, you know, even if they seem
not very
to be
happy.
Smiling on the outside when they react to it, you know, because of the way they are supposed to be as reactors, they seem to be smiling. But as a counselor and psychologist and psychotherapist, I do know that they're quite sad and depressed, and you know, and it shows in the way you work, you know. So yeah, it's kind of like that. Maybe at, you know, one point of time everything was so good. 2 years ago, I can't even imagine what those people are doing today, because they were so many reactors when we just started on YouTube two months ago we started, and there were so many people who I don't even see anymore. I mean, it's been a while since I've seen quite a few of them.
Yeah,
maybe more than 100 reactors and reaction channels. I don't even know where they are, whether they're alive, they're dead. I just hope they are well. I wish them all a happy new year if they're watching this reaction. I happen to know that we are still around. At one time, we would all watch each other's reactions, and many of us, I remember when we started, everyone was helping each other.
Yeah.
You know, we would literally have kind of a community.
But
today it's become like a competition.
Everyone's struggling with things.
And, you know, I don't like the way it has become. I often talk about it because on one side, there seem to be people who are giving all these fake reactions, which I don't like viewing anyway because I'm not really benefiting by watching them. And it's not good for me, who's an honest reactor. People like us who react openly and honestly. It's not good for us because everyone thinks we are like them, or we are supposed to be like them if they like those reactions. So things have changed a lot, and yeah, it may be a saturation point for all of us, and the results can be seen, you know, it can really be seen. Especially if you've been watching reactions like me for more than 2 years on YouTube, you definitely can see the saturation point has come. And yeah, there are different ways to look at it. I look at it positively, that I'm still here, I'm still reacting. Let's make the most of it. That's the way I look at life, and I do things with the blessings of God, so I'm not going to stop because I don't do anything wrong. If I do something wrong, it probably is because the guidelines and rules are just new and I'm not known about it. So anyway, yeah, that's all I have to say really. Let's end this reaction.
Yes.
Happy New Year 2022, all of you guys. Hope you have an amazing time and all your dreams, your resolutions that you'll probably be writing down soon come through and bear fruition. If they are meant to happen, they will. But you need to believe in it too.